Now let's look at all the heavy lifting that needs to be done by runtime in order to facilitate this MapReduce style of programming. The app developer writes his map function and reduce function and instantiates the programming library by calling MapReduce. And the programming library splits the input files that is provided by the user, that is the key value space provided by the user, into m splits. The number of splits of the input key value pairs, namely m, can be automatic by the programming system, or m can also be specified by the user. In any case, once m is specified or automatically determined by the programming framework, it splits the input key value space into m splits. The next thing that happens in the programming environment is to spawn the master for this particular MapReduce computation, and all the worker threads that are going to carry out the work involved in map functions and reduce functions. The master is special because the master is the one that is sort of overseeing the whole operation and keeping tab on which workers are doing what functions, when are they done, when to start new work, when to say that the computation is done. All of those chores are being orchestrated by this master. The next thing that happens is that the master is going to assign some number of worker threads as the mapper worker threads. And the number of mapper worker threads may correspond to the number of splits that it has done in the beginning. So if there are m splits, then m worker threads are going to be assigned to mapping function. So each worker thread is going to take one portion of the input file split that has been done and apply the map function on that particular input split. The next thing that happens is that the master assigns reduce task to some number of worker threads, and the number of reduces to be assigned to the workers R is something that is decided by the application. Recall in the example that I gave you about looking for specific names in an input corpus, the number of unique names is something that the app developer is specifying. That's where the number R comes from. That's the number of splits that the user is specifying, and that parameter is going to be used by the master to assign some number of workers as reducers. The next thing that the master does is to plumb the mapper to the reducers, because now when the mappers produce their output has to be sent over to the consumers of the intermediate results of the mapper, namely the reducers, and setting up this communication paths between the producers of data, the mappers, and the consumers of data, the reducers, is the plumbing that the master does as the next thing. Now it's time to get to work. The map phase, what it is going to do is, it is going to read its respective split. So each of these workers is assigned to the mapping function. So each of the worker is working on a particular split, and what they're going to do is read from the local disk the split that they've been assigned, parse the input, and then call the user-defined map function. The user-defined map function is the one that is doing the core of the work that needs to be done on the input data set to produce the intermediate output. The rest of it are things that needs to be done in order to facilitate the work to be carried out by the domain expert in the map function. And the intermediate key value pairs that will be produced by the mapper will be buffered in memory. So each one of these workers is doing a portion of processing the input key value pairs and producing their respective outputs. And periodically, the intermediate results are going to be written to files which are on the local disk of the worker, of the respective workers. For this guy, on its local disk, it's going to write the intermediate files corresponding to the output of the map function. Similarly, this worker is going to write to its local disk the intermediate files, and so on. And because the application developer has specified that there are R splits in the reducers, each worker, meaning each map function that is associated with that worker, is going to produce R intermediate file, one for each of the R workers that are going to be doing the reduce operation. And all of these intermediate files are stored on the local disk associated with each of these computational nodes carrying out the worker function corresponding to the map phase. And when they are done with the map operation for the split that they're handling, the worker will inform the master that I'm done. And what the master is waiting on is waiting on all of these mappers to get done before letting the workers to get going on the input data set. So in this sense, the master is like the conductor of an orchestra. He has started this mapping function, waiting for all of these guys to get done. And when they indicate that they have done their work by notifying the master, and all of the M mappers that have been assigned to these workers have completed that work, then the master says, okay, now it is time to move on to the reduce phase.